Welcome back to Sticker Mountain. Today, we are going to show you not only how to make a sticker sheet, but how to make one in three different ways. This video shows you method number one, so follow the links in the description to see the other two. Let's get started. Our first step is to open Adobe Illustrator and create a new document. For our example, we are creating a new file that is the size of a sheet of paper. However, we'll use the landscape orientation so that it's 8.5 inches tall and 11 inches wide. Our settings are in CMYK color mode to ensure accuracy between colors we see on the computer and when we print them. And then our raster effects is at its highest at 300 PPI. This is also important for high quality printed images. Then press create. Our next step is to create a rectangle. This will actually be the home for our stickers rather than the artboard itself. To create that rectangle, select the rectangle tool or the keyboard shortcut M. Then click and drag from the top left corner of the artboard down to the bottom right corner. Then to give us a little more wiggle room, we're going to expand our artboard by 1/2 inch on each side. To do this, click on the artboard tool or the keyboard shortcut Shift O. Then go to the dimensions at the top of the screen and type 11.5 for the width and 9 for the height. Then double click on the empty space to exit artboard mode. Finally, and this part is optional, you can give your sticker sheet curved corners. To do this, click on your rectangle and you can see these little circles in the corner. Double click one of those and this opens a transform panel on the right hand side. Under the rectangle properties, go to the corner section and make sure they're all locked and linked together. And then type in 0.125 into one of the boxes. Now you have curved corners. Last but not least, go to the color panel and switch your fill to off by clicking the square with the red line through it. Then click on your stroke and change that to a bright color, like red. And now you have yourself a rectangle. This step is also optional, but it's great for organizational purposes and is just a good habit to get into. Layers. Just like ogres and onions, our sticker sheets have layers. We're naming this layer background, and then go to the plus button at the bottom and add two more layers. Double click on the name and you can change it to one for stickers and another one for die lines. Then copy the rectangle with Command C and paste it into the die line layer with Command F. That way, it's easier for our laser as well as the artist handling your artwork. Now, this next step is pretty easy and up to your creative discretion. It's time to put in your artwork. I'm adding 6 Marty's representing our sports teams here in Colorado. Then I'm arranging them so that they're relatively evenly spaced and making sure there's enough space in between each sticker. As you can see, the PNGs came in huge. I'm making my dimensions a little more exact by going up to the dimensions and making each sticker 3.5 inches tall and keeping the dimensions locked so that the image doesn't skew or warp. Then with 3 of the stickers selected, I use the vertical align button to align the rows so that the bottom of each image is on one plane. Again, making it nice and neat. A couple of tweaks later and we now have our art on the sheet. Now let's make die lines for each individual sticker. This may seem a little tedious at first, but with some keyboard shortcuts, this can be done in no time. The first thing you need to do is select one of your stickers, in this case, the hockey player, and copy and paste in front with the keyboard shortcuts Command-C and Command-F. Then with that copy still selected, we're going to image trace this PNG. If you don't have it open already, go to Window and select Image Trace. From here, select the low color option. It may give you a message regarding loading time, but just press OK and let Illustrator work its magic. Now that it's all loaded, do not forget this step. With the image still selected, go to the top toolbar and click Expand. This turns your traced object into paths, like a vector image. Now click off of your object and double click it again to go into isolation mode, and click and delete all of the blank white background around your image. If we kept this white background, it would make it more difficult to create our die line later on. Now with that taken care of, double click outside of the artwork to exit isolation mode and select all of your art again. Then open the Pathfinder window and click Unite. As you can see, we have a nice silhouette of the image. If we kept that white background, it would have created a square, and that's not a great way to make a custom die line. Now with it still selected, go to the object dropdown, find path, and then select offset path. This opens a dialog box of how much we want to offset this path. For this example, we type in 0.0625 inches, with joins being round and the limit to 4, then press OK. Next, make sure everything is selected again, go back to the Pathfinder panel, and click Unite. This is to make sure there are no extra paths and it's one solid outline of our design. Otherwise, our laser will create cuts on these paths and that's just not good. The final step is to switch the fill and the stroke over in the color panel, or you can use the shortcut Shift X, and voila! We have our die cut line for our first sticker. Now, because we created our individual layers, I'm going to copy and paste in front this die line to be in our die line layer. Just use the shortcuts Command C and then Command F, and now we're going to speed through the rest of our stickers. Also, to make it even faster, you can create a shortcut for the offset path action. All you need to do is go to the Edit menu and select Keyboard Shortcuts, or the shortcut Command Option Shift K. Select Menu Commands and search for Offset Path. Select the empty square and type the keyboard shortcut you desire, such as Command 9 in our case. Now that all of our stickers have outlines, we're going to create a background for our stickers to live in. So in our background layer, create another rectangle the size of the artboard. Since the stroke is still on, press Shift X to swap the fill and stroke. You can create your background however you like, but for this example, we're going to create a gradient background with a sports themed pattern. To create the gradient, go to the gradient panel and select the freeform option. This gives us a lot of awesome potential for how we want our gradient to look. You can move these points around however you wish, and in this case, so that the team's colors match with each Marty. If you want to change the color of a point, all you have to do is double click on the circle in the middle of the point. You can change it through color, swatches, or through the eyedropper tool. I'll use the eyedropper tool to select the color on the hockey jersey. Now it's just moving the points around until you reach something you like. Our next step is to place the sports pattern. I saved mine in my libraries, so I'll drag it from there and place it on the board and make copies by pressing the Option and Shift keys while dragging the copy until it fills the background. Next, I'm going to lock the other layers and select all the patterns and group it together by pressing the shortcut Command G while making sure that the gradient rectangle isn't selected. With that rectangle and the pattern selected, I'll create a clipping mask. To create a clipping mask, go to Object and then down to Clipping Mask and click Make, or use the shortcut Command 7. Now we have a nice clean background for our stickers to live in. Next, to show people where this sticker sheet is from, I'm inserting one of our logos at the top. Now it's time to create some bleeds. This part is important so that the background doesn't show around your sticker, and to give the laser a little extra room to cut these stickers out. To do this, create a copy of the die line with Command C and Command F, and press Shift X to swap the stroke and fill and make the fill white. Next, offset the path the same as before and press OK. Make sure everything is selected and click Unite in the Pathfinder panel. Then select your white silhouette, copy it with Command C and paste it in front with Command F inside the sticker layer. Then use the shortcut Command left bracket to move it towards the back so you can see your sticker again. Now repeat this for the rest of the stickers. I did notice something with this soccer player sticker that I wanted to show you guys. We're going to change up the die line a bit so that the soccer ball is connected to Marty. That way there aren't two individual stickers. To do this, double click the die line to open the isolation mode. And with the direct selection tool, drag a square over an area of anchor points you don't want, and then press the minus pen button at the top. You do have to be careful because sometimes it may make the lines a little funny. So keep removing anchor points until there's a straight line, and then take a couple of points and drag those over to overlap the lines of the soccer ball. Select both outlines, go back to the Pathfinder tool, and unite them. Clean up the points if need be so that it's nice and smooth. Now back to your regularly scheduled time lapse. We have your finished sticker sheet. What's next? Creating an order and submitting your artwork to Sticker Mountain. It's easy, and with our quick turnaround times, you can expect to see your stickers in 3, 2, 1. If you'd like to see our other methods for creating a sticker sheet, check out the links in the description or click our playlist here. See you next time, Yetis.